So class, here's the remaining topic of the first unit, that is introduction to OOPs. Because this chapter consists of two units, first I've explained the principle and the second one is this. So here are the remaining topics that I'm going to explain today. So number one is types of Java program. So basically there are two types of program that can be created with the help of Java language. Number one is Java application and number two is Java applets. So these two type of programs we can create with the help of this language. First we will consider Java applications. So Java applications are also known as standalone system or standalone applications, because basically the trend is used to Java in developing large web enterprise in applications. Okay, so Java is widely accepted as the development technology for standalone application, means these are basically meant for desktop applications. So that's why they are known as standalone applications. And if we talk about the applets, so basically applet is what? An applet is a program written in Java programming language that can include HTML page in the same way as an image include in a page. So when you these use Java enabled technology with the browsers to view a page that contain an applet, so that applet code is transferred, okay, to your system and then it is executed by the browser, and that browser is JVM, Java Virtual Machine. So these applets can be downloaded with the help of JVM. Java, next is Java programming with BlueJay. So how you are going to perform your Java programs, because you are new to Java. So this is BlueJay is a software with the help of which you are going to perform. Basically BlueJay is a free Java environment, okay, from the University of Monash in Australia. It is a window based platform for JDK, means Java Development Kit. Before installing the BlueJay, we need to develop JDK 1.3. And if you want more information, or if you want to download, if you have your own desktops, so you can download BlueJay by visiting this site www.bluejay.org. That is free of cost, okay, it will take no charge. You can download your BlueJay if you have the desktops. Here is the icon, so it will look like this. You can download it, okay, from that website. So class, now I'm going to tell you the basic structure of a journal Java program. So the basic format of writing a program is Java is entirely different from other languages. So it is essential to know the points. So these are some important points. First I'll tell you the structure, then I'll go with that. Okay, now see here. Public class sample. You have done in class 8 also very short programs. That way only you can see. See, public is a access specifier. Then class, you will write it as a keyword. We have to write as it is. Then sample, you can take any name. Okay, this is the name of the class. I have taken sample. Now, these are the opening braces. And this public static void main string args. This is the common line. This is the main function that we have to write in every Java program. Okay. Now again we are opening it. Then we are initializing some variables. Int. Int means integer type. Means 1, 2, 3. Not in decimal. Okay. Like 1, 2, 3, 4. It couldn't be like 1.1, 2.3. So we have to take the integer values. So I have taken a equals to 10, b equals to 15 and c equals to 0 with a semicolon. So this is what? This is the declaration of data, which type of data you are going to use in the program. Then this c equals to a plus b. So we are doing the sum basically. So in c variable, we are going to store a plus b, means 10 plus 15. Whatever the result will be, it will be printed in system.out.println, means it is a output statement or a thing to display the output. So thus in double quotes, we will write whatever we want to print. So we want to print the sum of the two numbers plus c, means plus indicates here ki they are separated, a message will be displayed along with the variable. Okay, so whatever the sum will be, it will be displayed. Now these are the closing braces. This is the closing braces of this. See here, class closing braces is this and main function closing braces is this. So this way we used to write the basic format of the program. Now I tell you some important terms over here. See, number one, comments in a program. As you know, these are non-executable commands in Java. Okay, these are just to make user understand that what an action is going on. So class second was declaration of class. So it contains the word access specifier. See, whatever the access specifier is there, public. So we have to define it here. Okay, it have the class keyword also and class name. I have taken sample. Okay, then second is declaration of main function. See here, public static void main we have declared. Means we are going to put the opening braces, then the curly braces, and the termination of the statement will be by semicolon. And the last one is the output statement, that is system.out.print. Means whatever we use to display, whatever we want to display our message, it should be in double quotes. So this way you will write the basic structure of the program with the important terms that are included, that are important while writing a Java program. And now we have done with two chapters. Number one was Java and number introduction of Java, and number two is elementary of object and classes. Hopefully you will done your work of both the chapters on time.